1920s, maybe early 30s, Chaim Weizmann used to come to Detroit, as he would many cities, to visit and speak with the Jewish community about his efforts to begin the establishment of a Jewish state in Palestine. And my dad would hear about these things, and he would go to these meetings. He would write a nice check, like $500, which was a lot of money back then, but he really believed in that. One night, a neighbor of ours asked my father to come to his home. There was going to be a meeting. The purpose of the meeting was to decide what to do for all of these Jewish immigrants who were coming into the new state of Israel. What they, Detroit pro-Israel Jews, could do to help this young country in absorbing all of these aliyah that were coming. And my dad was probably one of the only people in the city, in the community, who was involved in construction materials. So they got my dad to go over there in 1949 and to survey the situation, so to speak. And he did, and he decided they needed everything, of course. But more fundamentally, what they needed was an adequate supply of crushed stone to build roads with, to make concrete with, to build buildings with. And they had a number of quarries in the country already, but the quarries, they were owned by the Histadrut, and they were pretty inefficient. And he went to see Ben-Gurion and told him what he was there for. And he said, we're going to buy and build American machinery and bring it over here and install it, including the processing plant for this crushing, screening the stone, and the quarry trucks and shovel and so on. He said, but we need to be able to bring that equipment in duty-free. And secondly, we need to be able to borrow Israeli pounds in the banks here for our local needs. Ben-Gurion thought that was a great idea, and they shook hands on it. And that was the deal. There was nothing on paper. He proceeded to go back home, go to another meeting with these same fellows that he met with down the street from home. They put together several million dollars. And the corporation, and my dad oversaw the spending of that money and building the quarry and starting it up. And he spent half of his life in the years from 1949 to 1954 in Israel. And it changed his life somewhat, as you can imagine.